So welcome to the today class on the characteristics of DC motor. See, here we are going to study the different characteristics of DC motor. The first one is the starting characteristics of motor. Starting characteristics, nothing but from these characteristics we come to know how the DC motor will be performing at the time of starting. That means how much time it will take to reach the 50% of speed as well as 100% of the speed. The second one is the performance characteristics. The performance characteristics are nothing but in this characteristics we are going to study the what is the efficiency of the motor, how much the motor is giving the output power, at what speed it is running if you apply the some amount of a load, how much current it is taking, how much power is actually developed in the motor, how much loss occurs in the motor. Everything we are going to study in the performance characteristics of a motor. The third one is the regulation characteristics are nothing but how the speed of the motor will be changes, at given amount of the torque. Nothing but suppose we have DC motor. On the DC motor, we apply some amount of load. At that load, now we are going to apply the speed control. When you are going to apply the speed control, how the motor speed will be changes. Those characteristics we are studying under the regulation characteristics of a DC motor. These characteristics are very very important when the motor is using for the drives. So driving is nothing but the speed of the motor should be controlled by the some power electronic circuit. In that cases, these characteristics are very very important. The fourth one is the torque versus armature current characteristics. Torque is nothing but a twisting movement at the axis of the armature. This is the mechanical quantity. For given value of armature current in a motor, how much torque is developed in a motor? That is very very important for driving any type of load. That characteristics we are studying for given motor under the torque versus armature current characteristics. Sometimes this characteristic is electrical characteristics. Fifth one is the speed versus armature current characteristics. As the armature current is increases, how the speed of the motor will be changes. Sometimes it is also important because the armature current taken by the motor is highly depending upon the how much mechanical load we are applying on the motor. Suppose we apply some amount of mechanical load, now the motor will be running at 100 rpm, so 1000 rpm. Let me take some value. You apply the mechanical load on the motor so that the motor will be running at 1000 RPM. You further increase the load on the motor, the speed of the motor will be drastically goes to the 500 RPM or 100 RPM. That's why we should know what is the, how the speed of the motor will be changes as the armature current is increases, where the armature current taken by the motor is highly depending upon the mechanical load. Unless until if you are not changing the mechanical load of the motor does not take the more amount of armature current. Motor does not take the more amount of armature. Whatever the motor it is, whether it is shunt motor, series motor, compound motor, whatever it is, the armature current in the motor will be increases only when if you are increasing the mechanical load of the motor. If you increase the mechanical load of the motor. That characteristics we are studying under the speed versus armature current characteristics. Sixth one is the speed versus torque characteristics. Speed versus torque characteristics. See here, another name for this characteristics is the mechanical characteristics. Mechanical characteristics. Mechanical characteristics. See here. So why we are calling this characteristics as a mechanical means any mechanical quantity, any mechanical system, the primary thing is torque, the effect is speed. Effect is nothing but in electrical circuit, voltage is the cause, where the current is the effect. In a mechanical system, the torque is the cause, where the effect is the speed. See here, these two quantities. So whatever the quantity we have taken the x-axis, and the quantity we have taken the y-axis. These two quantities are related to the mechanical only. That's why we are calling as a mechanical characteristics. Mechanical. But in this lecture, we are studying only the three characteristics for the shunt motor, series motor, compound motor. All these motors are coming under the self-excited DC motors. We are not studying the separately excited DC motor because the shunt motor characteristics almost are equal to the separately excited DC motor characteristics. If we know the shunt motor characteristics, that is equal to the separately excited characteristics. That's why we are not separately studying the separately excited DC motor characteristics. We are studying only the shunt motor characteristics, series motor characteristics, and compound motor characteristics. Finally, we are comparing the all the motors. Only the three characteristics are there. One is primarily three characteristics are there. One is torque versus armature current characteristics. Torque versus armature current characteristics. Armature current characteristics. The second one is the speed versus armature current characteristics. Third one is the speed versus torque characteristics. The first characteristic is nothing but a torque versus armature characteristics. Another name for this one is the electrical characteristics. This another name is the electrical characteristics. The second one is the speed versus armature characteristics. Third one is the speed versus torque characteristics. Another name for this one is the mechanical characteristics. Mechanical characteristics. See, in case of DC motor, we have a shunt motor, separately excited motor, series motor, and compound motors are there. But here we are going to study the shunt motor, series motor, and compound motors. The three characteristics we are going to study for the shunt motor, series motor, as well as the compound motors, as well as the compound motor. See here, before going to study these characteristics, if we observe the first one, torque versus armature current, nothing but a, we should know what is the relation between the torque and armature current in a DC motor. Already we know the relation between the torque versus torque to the armature current, that is, torque is directly proportional to, the torque is directly proportional to A into IA. This is the first equation. So why we are taking this equation means to study the torque versus armature current characteristics of a different motors. The second one is the speed versus armature current characteristics. See here, to develop the relation between speed and armature current, here we have taken the DC shunt motor. Now apply the KVL in this loop, EB plus again voltage rise IARA. Again, it is voltage fall minus V equal to 0. Now, EB equal to V minus IA, RA. This you take it as a equation 1. So, already we know the expression for the EB. EB is nothing but the back EMF in a motor, nothing but dynamically induced voltage in armature. The expression for the back EMF is same as the voltage induced in a generator. So this EB equal to here, EB equal to, in place of EB, you can write it as a Zn pi by 60 into P by A. This is equal to V minus IA RA. V minus IA RA. Now here we want the speed, so you keep the speed here. V minus IARA divided by flux into constant. Nothing but this Z, see here, Z 60 P by A, this total thing is constant. The total thing is constant. So that you have taken as a K. That you have taken as a K, that side. Now, speed is proportional to V minus IARA divided by pi. This is the second equation. What we have to require to develop the second characteristics. Second characteristics. Now, finally we have taken the speed of a motor proportional to V minus IARA divided by flux. This you take it as a second equation. This you take it as a second equation. Now we are going to study each characteristics for the shunt motor. First we are taking the shunt motor. See here, we give the shunt motor. For the shunt motor, we are going to study the torque versus armature current characteristics. Torque versus armature current characteristics. See here, to study the torque versus armature current characteristics of a shunt motor, we have taken the relation, first relation, that is, TA proportional to flux into armature current flux into armature. We have taken this expression. To develop the first characteristics, nothing but a torque versus armature current. Torque versus armature current characteristics to study this one. In case of a shunt motor, the developed torque in a motor is directly proportional to the flux and also proportional to the armature current. Whereas the armature current taken by the motor is highly depending upon the how much mechanical load we are applying on the motor. In case of shunt motor, the shunt field current is constant. The flux is constant. Almost all the flux is constant. So, armature torque is directly proportional to the IA. As the current taken by the motor increases, the developed torque in armature also will be increases. So, how this armature current is increases means by increasing the mechanical load on the motor. Now, you take the armature current on x-axis and torque on a y-axis. It is simply representing a straight line passing through the origin. This is the ideal case. Practically, what happened means the armature current increases, armature reaction will be increases. Because of the armature reaction, the main flux will be decreases. Whenever the main flux is decreases, the torque developed in the motor also will be decreases as the current is increased in this manner. Not exactly the straight line. This one. This is practical case. So why this characteristic is bended or down some value means it is because of the armature reaction. Whereas the armature reaction is highly depending upon the armature current. Because of the armature reaction, the flux per pole will be decreased, so that the flux also will be decreases as the current is increases, so the torque developed in the motor will be decreases. To represent that one here, not exactly the straight line, but high value of the armature current. This is the torque versus armature current characteristics of a DC shunt motor. So that is the reason that the load which requires a proportional torque, so in that case we are selecting a shunt motor to drive that load. Speed versus armature current. Speed versus armature current characteristics. To study the speed versus armature current characteristics, now you have to take the second relation, that is N is proportional to V minus IA RU. See here, N is proportional to V minus IARA divided by the flux. Already we know that in a shunt motor, the flux is constant. So, the N is proportional to V minus IARA. As the current is increases, as the armature current on the motor is increases, IARA will be increases. So the speed of the motor will be decreases. See here, if you take the armature current on x-axis, speed on a y-axis, this is the no load speed. The motor will be running at a higher speed at no load, where the motor is taking a less amount of current. As the load of the motor is increases, the armature current will be increases, IRA drop will be increases, now the speed of the motor will be decreases from this value. This is the speed versus armature current characteristics of a shunt motor. Speed versus armature current characteristics of a shunt motor. Third one is the mechanical characteristics, nothing but a speed versus torque characteristics. Mechanical characteristics means the speed as well as the torque is related to the only the mechanical system. That's why these two quantities, both quantities are mechanical quantities only. That's why we call it as a mechanical characteristic. So how we are going to develop this characteristic means, actually we are not conducting any test on a DC motor to develop this characteristics. Once you know the first characteristics and second characteristics, nothing but torque versus armature current, speed versus armature current means, see here, you take a serial number, armature current, corresponding torque, corresponding speed. Here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like that, you can go for the anywhere. Suppose here, if you take the 1 ampere of current, for 1 ampere of current, how much is the torque? That value you take here. Same 1 ampere of current, how much is the speed? That value you take here. Next, second case, 2 amperes. For the first characteristics, you find that for 2 amperes, how much is the torque developed in a motor? That value you have to take here. The same manner, for the 2 amperes of current, how much is the speed? That you have to calculate from the second characteristic, you take that value. Similarly, 3 amperes, 4 amperes, 5 amperes, like this. Like this, you go for the up to the rated current of a motor, you note on the same value of armature current, you note on the torque and the speed from the first two characteristics. Now, you take the torque on an x-axis, speed on a y-axis, torque on a x-axis, and speed on a y-axis. If you draw a graph, means you are getting the same characteristics of this one. You are getting the same profile here. Same profile. But the magnitude of the torque and the speed will be different. Because the torque is depending upon the armature current. That's why here, in the third characteristics, we have taken the torque on x-axis, where speed we have taken y-axis. So this profile of this graph is same as the speed versus armature current characteristics for any type of motor. That means shunt motor, series motor, or compound, whatever it is. But then this characteristic is similar to the speed versus armature current characteristics. But here, we are not conducting any test on the motor to develop this one. These characteristics are developed based upon the first two characteristics. Now, so in this manner, we can develop the characteristics of a shunt motor. Now we are going to see the series motor. In series motor, again we are taking the first characteristics, that is armature torque versus armature current. Now here, draw the circuit diagram for the series motor. This is the armature. This is the field winding of series motor. Here we are applying the voltage of V volts. It is taking a current of IL. The current which is flowing here, nothing but IL, armature current. To represent this machine as a motor, here you note down the M. Nothing but a motor. Nothing but a motor. In this case, load current is equal to the armature current. How much current is flowing at the supply? Nothing but here. Not load. Supply current equal to armature current. How much current is flowing here? The same amount of current is flowing through the armature. Same amount of current is flowing through the armature. The same amount of current also will be flowing through the field winding. Field winding. Now we are going to study this one. So taken the expression, armature torque is directly proportional to the flux and armature current. Flux and armature. In case of series motor, the flux per pole is directly proportional to the armature current. Flux per pole is directly proportional to the armature current till the poles are saturated. That is very, very important. Till the saturation. Nothing but the poles are not saturated. The flux coming from the pole is directly proportional to the armature current. Now, the torque is directly proportional to Ia square. In place of pi, you substitute I. This is the expression for the torque up to the saturation. Till the saturation. Next, the poles are saturated. Even though, if we are increasing the current through the field winding, the flux does not increase. Nothing but flux in a machine is constant. Now the torque is directly proportional to Ia. Armature current only. So once the poles are saturated, torque is directly proportional to armature current. Now we are going to draw the graph. Now take the armature current on x-axis, torque on y-axis, we are assuming that the poles are saturated at this point. Here you take the poles are saturated. Up to this value, torque is directly proportional to the scale of the armature current, nothing but a parabola. Once the poles are saturated, now the downward torque in a motor is directly proportional to the armature current, nothing but a straight line. In this region, torque is directly proportional to Ia square. Torque is directly proportional to Ia. This is the torque versus armature current characteristics of a DC series motor. Now, we are going to see what is the speed versus armature current characteristics of a DC motor. Second one. Again, we have taken the same expression, speed expression. Speed is directly proportional to V minus Ia, Ra by pi. See here, Ia, Ra, we are assuming that is constant. Even though, if we take the armature current is 20 ampere, full load current, for a well-designed machine, Ra value will be less than the 1. So this quantity will be very, very small. That we are neglecting. Now the speed is inversely proportional to the flux. Nothing but If the flux is low, the motor will be running at a higher speed. The flux is higher, the motor will be running at a lower speed. Nothing but it is representing the rectangular hyperbola. If we draw a graph, nothing but if we take n as x proportional to 1 by pi as a y, xy equal to constant, nothing but rectangular hyperbola. If we take the armature current on an x-axis, speed on a y-axis, if we draw a graph, we are getting this type of profile, rectangular hyperbola. Nothing but the armature current is low. In case of series motor, the flux also low, so the speed of the motor will be very higher. When the armature current is higher, the flux will be higher, nothing but speed of the motor will be lower. See, once the poles are saturated, here we are assuming that poles are saturated, the flux is constant, so the speed of the motor will be constant further. See, if you observe this point, this is the point where the motor is running at a very high speed. Nothing but no load. If you start the series motor at no load, it is taking a very less amount of current, the flux will be lesser, the speed of the motor will be very higher, armature will be running at a very high speed. Because of centrifugal forces developed armature, the armature may come out of the mission, it will be damaged the mission as well as the people which are very near to the mission. That's why we should not run the series motor at a light loads, or we should not start the series motor at a no load. This is very, very important question. Why the series motor not started at a no load? Always it is suggested that the series motor should be started with some value of the mechanical load on the motor. And put some value on the mechanical load on the motor, then only give the supply to the series motor. Otherwise, if you are not applying any mechanical load, it will be running at very high speeds. The armature may come out of the mission. It is dangerous to the mission as well as people very near to the mission. The second one is that if you observe this characteristics, first characteristics, the torque developed in a series motor up to the saturation is directly proportional to the scale of the current. Nothing but a high amount of the starting torque will be developed in a mission. So that is the reason that conventionally in locomotives they use the DC series motor. Suppose, why the locomotive, the motor which is there in a locomotive requires a high starting torque means, suppose we are assuming that the train is stopped in a one railway station. Now the locomotive has to pick the remaining compartments along with the engine by through the motor. At the time of starting, it requires a high amount of starting torque to move the total mass, the mass of all compartments. Once it is started, it does not require that much of torque. So, in case of series motor, it gives the high starting torque. That is the reason that in locomotives, conventionally, the series motors are used. In cranes also, they use only the series motors. Because to lift some weight, it requires a high starting torque. The high starting torque can give only the series motor. These are some of the important questions in a torque versus armature current characteristics and speed versus armature current characteristics, from the speed versus armature current characteristics, why series motor not to stop and run no load? That is very, very important question. Next, now we come to the third characteristics. In third characteristics, already we know how to develop the third characteristics, that is speed versus torque, speed versus armature torque. Again, you take the table, serial number, armature current, and torque, speed. 1 ampere, 2 ampere, 3 ampere, 4 ampere, like that, you go up to the rated value, 8 amperes. For given value of current, we are calculate what is the torque as well as the speed. 1 ampere of current, how much is the torque? How much is the speed? You note down here. Same manner, 2, 3 amperes, 4 amperes, 5 amperes, like that. Now you take the torque on a x-axis, speed on a y-axis. If you draw a graph, means you are getting the same type of profile. So what is the profile of the graph in a second characteristic? The same profile you are getting for the third characteristic, nothing but a mechanical characteristic. It is a curve drawn between the speed versus the torque developed in a motor. The torque developed in a motor. Next, we are going to see the compound motors. Another compound motors. Under the compound motors, basically there are two types of motors are there. One is cumulative compound motor. Cumulative compound motor. The second one is the differentially compound motor. Differentially compound motor. The cumulative compound is nothing but in case of compound motor, there are two types of flux are there. One is shunt flux, another one is the series flux. If the shunt flux is added with the series flux, see here, shunt flux, another one is the series flux. Shunt flux and series flux. If the shunt flux and series flux is added, the total flux will be increases. The type of motor is nothing but a cumulative compound motor. Nothing but the series flux is added with a shunt flux. In case of differentially compound motor, the total flux is equal to shunt flux plus series flux But series flux is opposing the shunt flux. The resultant flux will be decreases. Pi SH plus Pi SE, both in same direction, that is the cumulative compound motor. If the series flux is opposite the shunt flux, the type of motor is nothing but a differentially compound motor. Now we are going to see the armature torque versus armature current characteristics of a cumulative compound motor. See here, you have taken the torque versus armature current characteristics. The simple manner you can write it is a TA versus IA. Again, we have taken the basic equation. The basic equation is torque is directly proportional to flux into armature current. In case of a cumulative compound motor, this flux is equal to, this total flux is equal to shunt flux plus series flux. See here, the series flux is function of a armature current. Now, what is the physical meaning of function of armature current means? As the armature current increases, the series flux also will be increases. The armature current is decreases, the series flux also will be decreases. But the shunt flux is constant. So that is the meaning of the series flux is function of a armature current. See here, the series flux is function of a armature current. Now, if we draw the characteristics of torque versus armature current, take the armature current on x-axis and torque on a y-axis. Initially, the load on the motor is very less. Nothing but a light load condition. Armature current is lesser, series flux is lesser, the dominating only the shunt flux. The total flux equal to the shunt flux. So the torque versus armature current characteristics is same as the shunt motor. But in case of shunt motor, that is the constant. See here, you are drawn the, this is the shunt motor characteristics, straight line. But in the ideal case, it is bended here. This is practical case, this is the ideal case, shunt motor. As long as current is lesser, the series flux is lesser, the dominating flux is shunt flux. So, the characteristics of cumulative compound motor is same as the shunt motor, the low armature current is lesser, up to here. The armature current increases, the series flux increases, now it is going to affect the shunt flux. In case of cumulative compound motor, the series flux is added to the shunt flux, the total flux will be increases. Here the flux is increases, armature current also increases. So, the torque developed in the motor will be increased in this manner. This is for the cumulative compound motor. See here, this is for the shunt motor. Now we are going for the differentially compound motor. In case of differentially compound motor, again we are taking up the same expression, torque is directly proportional to flux into armature current, whereas flux equal to shunt flux plus series flux, where the series flux is function of a armature current. As long as the armature current is lesser, the shunt flux is more, so the net flux is shunt flux only. So the characteristics of a differentially compound motor is same as the shunt motor up to the low value, nothing but up to here. In case of differentially compound motor, as the armature current increases, the series flux will be increases. That is opposing the shunt flux, the net flux will be decreases. Nothing but in this expression, the current will be increases, the flux will be decreases. Now here, from this portion it slowly increases, and further increase the armature current, it comes to the zero. Sometimes it goes to the negative value also. So what is the meaning? What is the torque develop is going to the negative value means the series flux is more than the shunt flux. The series flux is more than the shunt flux. The motor will be running in a reverse direction. That is the reason that we, in rare applications only, the differentially coupled motor is used. Very rare, because the armature current is low, the developed torque is in a motor will be goes to the negative value. Actually, the motor has to run in this direction. Now it will be running in a opposite direction. The armature current is more. So that's why rare applications only they are using the differentially coupled motor. This is for the differentially coupled. This is for differentially coupled motor. See here, this is for shunt motor. This is for shunt motor. This is for the cumulative compound motor. This is for the differentially compound motor. In case of cumulative compound motor, the torque is more than the shunt motor. But in case of differentially compound motor, the torque is less than the shunt motor for a high value of armature current. Sometimes the developed torque also may go to the negative also. Now we are going to see the speed versus armature current characteristics of Now again you are taking the for cumulative compound motor. For cumulative compound motor, again you take the basic equation, that is N is proportional to V minus IaRa by pi. Nothing but take this is constant. Now speed of the motor is inversely proportional to the flux. The same equation, whenever we take this is constant, the same equation will be modified as a pi. Now here, in case of compound motor, the total flux is equal to shunt flux plus series flux, where the series flux is function of a armature current. It is very, very important. In function of a armature current. Now here, for low value of armature current, series flux is low, the total flux equal to shunt flux only. So the speed versus armature current characteristics of a cumulative compound motor is same as the shunt motor for low value of armature current. See here, now take the armature current on a x axis, speed on a y axis. Already we know the speed versus current were characteristics of a shunt motor, that is this one. This is for shunt motor. For low value of armature current up to here, the characteristics of cumulative component motor is same as the shunt motor, because shunt flux is dominating the series flux. As the armature current increases, the series flux will be increases, the total flux in the motor will be increases, the speed of the motor will be decreases. So up to here it is okay. After this point, the speed of the motor will be decreases drastically. This is for the cumulative compound motors. This characteristics are nothing but a cumulative compound motor. As the armature current increases, the series flux increases, net flux in the motor will be increases, the speed of the motor will be drastically decreases. Now come to the differentially compound motor. Differentially compound motor. You take up the same expression. N is inversely proportional to the flux. This is equal to shunt flux plus series flux. Whereas series flux is function of a, it is a function of a armature current. It is a function of armature current. As long as the armature current is lesser, the magnitude of series flux is lesser, so the net flux is shunt flux only. The characteristics of differentially compound motor is same as the shunt motor up to here. Right? You further increase the armature current, the series flux will be increases, the net flux will be decreases, because it is a differentially compound motor. The series flux is opposite the shunt flux, so the net flux will be decreases, the speed of the motor will be increases. See here. The current is increases in this manner, the speed of the motor will be increases. Now, the same diagram, if we draw the series motor characteristics, this is the series motor. This is for the series motor. This is for the differentially compound motor. This is for the shunt motor. This is for the cumulative compound motor. This is for the series motor. This is the comparison of the different motors of the speed versus armature current characteristics of a motor. See, in case of cumulative compound motor, differentially compound motor, we know the what is the relation between the armature current versus the torque, armature current versus the speed. Once you know these two characteristics, automatically we know the procedure how to develop the mechanical characteristics of a cumulative compound motor as well as a differentially compound motor. The mechanical characteristics of cumulative compound motor or differentially compound motor is the profile of the graph is same as the speed versus armature current characteristics. In case of a differentially compound motor, if we develop the speed versus torque, we are getting the this type of profile for differentially compound motor. Same manner for the cumulative compound motor, if you develop the speed versus armature current characteristics, we are getting the this type of characteristics. Now, lastly, we are comparing the torque versus armature current characteristics of all the motors. Nothing but a shunt motor, series motor, differentially compound motor, and just already we studied everything, just we are drawing in the same graph. In case of shunt motor, take the armature current on x-axis, torque on a y-axis, In case of shunt motor, that is the straight line. For higher values, because of the armature reaction, it will be bending. Because of the armature reaction, the flux for the pole will be decreases for high value of armature. This is for the shunt motor. Next, already we developed for the cumulative compound motor. For low value of current, for cumulative compound motor, same. After that, it will be increases in this manner. This is for the cumulative compound motor. Differentially compound motor, up to low value of armature current, it follows the shunt motor characteristics. After that, if increase the goes to the negative value, this is for the differentially compound motor. Just now we studied differentially compound motor. In case of series motor, see here, up to the saturation, it go parabola. After that, it follows the straight line. This is for the series motor. So we have a four different motors. One is shunt motor, series motor, cumulative compound motor, differentially compound motor. All torque versus armature current characteristics you have drawn on same. So these are the different characteristics of a shunt motor, series motor, compound motor, differentially compound motor. Once you know the characteristics of shunt motor, automatically the separately excited DC motor almost the same as the shunt motor characteristics. Suppose in case of a shunt motor, because of the armature reaction, the flux per pole will be decreases at a high value of armature current. The same thing does not happen in case of a separately excited DC motor. Because there is no connection between the field winding to the armature circuit. The field winding is separately excited by some source. So there is no effect in an armature reaction in case of a even the armature reaction is there, but that will be little in case of a separately excited DC motor. Thank you. Speed versus armature. Now again you are taking the first cumulative compound motor. For cumulative compound motor, again you take the basic equation, that is N is proportional to V minus Ia Ra by pi. Nothing but take this is constant. The speed of the motor is inversely proportional to the flux. Same equation, whenever you take this is constant, same equation will be modified as a pi. case of compound motor, the total flux is equal to shunt flux plus series flux, where the series flux is function of a armature current. It is very, very important. In function of a armature current. Now here, for low value of armature current, series flux is low, the total flux equal to shunt flux only, so the speed versus armature current characteristics of a cumulative compound motor is same as the shunt motor for low value of armature current. See here, now take the armature current on a x-axis, speed on a y-axis. Already we know the speed versus current characteristics of a shunt motor, that is this one. This is for shunt motor. For low value of armature current up to here, the characteristics are cumulative compound motor is same as the shunt motor because shunt flux is dominating the series flux. As armature current increases, the series flux will be increases, the total flux in the motor will be increases, the speed of the motor will be decreases drastically. So up to here it is okay. After this point, the speed of the motor will be decreases drastically. This is for the cumulative compound motors. This characteristics are nothing but a cumulative compound motor. As the armature current increases, the series flux increases, net flux in the motor will be increases, the speed of the motor will be drastically decreases. Now come to the differentially compound motor. Differentially compound motor. You take up the same expression, N is inversely proportional to the flux. This is equal to shunt flux plus series flux, whereas series flux is function of a, it is a function of a armature current. As long as armature current is lesser, the magnitude of series flux is lesser, so the net flux is shunt flux only. The characteristics of differentially compound motor is same as the shunt motor up to here. Right? You further increase the armature current, the series flux will be increases, the net flux will be decreases because it is a differentially compound motor. The series flux is opposite the shunt flux, so the net flux will be decreases, the speed of the motor will be increases. See here, the current is increases in this manner, the speed of the motor will be increases. Now, the same diagram, if you draw the series motor characteristics, this is the series motor. This is for the differentially compound motor. This is for the shunt motor. This is for the cumulative compound motor. This is for the series motor. This is the comparison of the different motors motors of the speed versus armature current characteristics of a motor. And speed versus armature current characteristics of a motor. See, in case of cumulative compound motor, differentially compound motor, we know the what is the relation between the armature current versus the torque, armature current versus the speed. Once you know these two characteristics, automatically we know the procedure how to develop the mechanical characteristics of a cumulative compound motor as well as a differentially compound motor. The mechanical characteristics of cumulative compound motor or differentially compound motor is the profile of the graph is same as the speed versus armature current characteristics. Speed versus armature current. In case of a differentially compound motor, if we develop the speed versus torque, we are getting the this type of profile for differentially compound motor. Same manner for the cumulative compound motor, if you develop the speed versus armature current characteristics, you are getting the this type of characteristics. This type of characteristics. Now, lastly, we are comparing the torque versus armature current characteristics of all the motors. Nothing but a shunt motor, series motor, differentially compound motor, and just already we studied everything, just we are drawing in the same graph. In case of shunt motor, take the armature current on x-axis, torque on a y-axis, In case of shunt motor, that is the straight line, for higher values, because of the armature reaction, it will be bending. Because of the armature reaction, the flux for the pole will be decreases for high value of armature. This is for the shunt motor. This is for the shunt motor. Next, already we developed for the cumulative compound motor. For low value of current, for cumulative compound motor, same. After that, it will be increases in this manner. This is for the cumulative compound motor. Differentially compound motor. Up to low value of armature current, it follows the shunt motor characteristics. After that, if increase the goes to the negative value, this is for the differentially compound motor. Just now we studied differentially compound motor. Differentially compound motor. In case of series motor, see here. Up to the saturation, it go parabola. After that, it follows the straight line. This is for the series motor. So we have a four different motors. One is shunt motor, series motor, cumulative compound motor, differentially compound motor. All torque versus armature current characteristics we have drawn on same. On same graph. So these are the different characteristics of a shunt motor, series motor, compound motor, differentially compound motor. Once you know the characteristics of shunt motor, automatically the separately excited DC motor almost are same as the shunt motor characteristics. Suppose in case of a shunt motor, because of the armature reaction, the flux per pole will be decreases at a high value of armature current. The same thing does not happen in case of a separately excited DC motor. Because there is no connection between the field winding to the armature circuit. The field winding is separately excited with some source. So there is no effect in an armature reaction in case of a even the armature reaction is there, but that will be little in case of a separately excited DC motor, separately excited DC motor. Thank you.